Thank you for joining. So we urge everybody when you join, you share, please. And so we thank you so much. Keep sharing. Once you come online, you share extensively. Let's have everybody on board before we pass this message very clearly. And of course, God bless you all. Okay, thank you. We are very happy that despite the issues affecting our revolution, we have come to the understanding We have come to the understanding that there is only one thing that is going to get us out of the dilemma that we now find ourselves into. And you know, the exclusive nature of the Ambazonian War of Independence is the most shocking things. Is the most shocking thing that a lot of people, you know, have come to refuse to accept the reality because of their personal aggrandizement. And today I'll be talking about what I prefer to term certificate of non-conviction. For others of you who know about, everybody who's in the diaspora must have done what they call the certificate of non-conviction. And if I am perplexed sometime when I watch men that I'm supposed to respect come and behave hypocritically, and you know, they make a fool of themselves out of their personal beliefs in issues that are not favorable to our independence. And I ask myself many a times, why is it that we have become so dishonest to our own selves? You know, personally, as Eric TATAW, I have no friend and no enemy in this revolution. I only have a few people who have decided to corrode and destroy the image of this revolution. A few people who see white and they call it black. And of course, I have other issues with some fake profiles who have decided to think that this revolutionary movement of the Ambazonian people is a matter of joke. And so they find themselves very wanting each time very appropriate and significant strategies are proposed. You know, because they have failed in their own lyric corners to initiate the much needed strategic movements in this revolution, they would probably want to think that because there are strategies that are workable, and even when they have refused vehemently out of their own kind of, you know, funny behaviors to identify with those particular principles that are workable for the revolution, they will think that you know, this is not supposed to go this way, because as a matter of fact, they do not just want to give it a try. However, the Ambazonian people are not out to have people give them a try on what they think and know is workable. And that is why today, despite the, you know, the fetish things I've done on my accounts, on my phone lines and everything, try to monitor me, all of those. Yesterday I was writing to one of the crooks and criminals who is trying to play issues on my account, and who are always trying to intercept my live broadcast, trying to disturb my phone lines and all of those. And I think we are gradually getting a more secured way that we'll be doing our things. That notwithstanding, I want to announce officially to all of them, including all their fake profiles, that I am here to stay, and that I am not going to be, you know, to be bullied, because I am the chief bully myself, the chief bully of liars. And so you cannot bring lies to come and bully honesty and truth. And I will also talk extensively about this concept that some petty, controversial minds are trying to bring up about Ambazonian women. And I will let them know a couple of things, because it is my, you know, my primary objective to make sure that I disseminate their anti-revolutionary moves by trying to attach my outings to the violation of the rights of women of Ambazonia. No, Ambazonian, the Ambazonian community or communities in various parts of the world and on Ground Zero, they have real and true women of valor, not some nincompoops and walkabouts that you call women. I want to say this very clearly, that I am one person who is very meticulous in his declarations. And when I say A, I know why I'm saying A. And when I say B, I know why I'm saying B. And so today, I want to clean the house. I want to make sure that all these people who want to think, including their masters, who think that I can be, my views can be subjugated and go under theirs, because they assume that they have had a catch on the fact that this guy talked about one or two or three women. And so they want to use this general Western phenomena where you think because this man spoke about these women, oh, all women should rally. Ambazonian women are not stupid. And I will tell you a lot of things, and I will show you some screenshots today where you would begin to understand my stand and why they call me Eric Tato. Look, let me say something. A lot of you don't understand. When some people say talk strategy, don't insult. In war, one of the strategies is insulting your enemy and belittling them and making sure that they don't exist. And so we for people who don't know, in this movement, there are many enemies. One, I have named it before, and I will still continuously name it, that there are bigger enemies in the house than La République du Cameroun. So when I see people like Jumba Aku, even if you tell him to come and watch, I want to tell him little lessons, because I call all these people big brothers behind the scene. They don't listen. And once you don't listen, before I come and talk about everybody, I know what I'm saying. Today, I will talk about the 12 apostles of fire. That Della is there. He's watching me. I want him to listen very well and to tell them, all of them, even some of people who are in the great, they call that other group great minds. They are also there. I see Della, he has gone away. He has gone off. You're going to come back. So when you see people who think that this revolution is business, you know, when they think that these people who are dying, they'll always come and use the name of people are dying, let's do this, because they think that when you use that word, people are dying, people understand that, oh, you care about the people who are dying. By now, the Ambazonian people already know those who care about who people who are dying on Ground Zero. Those who care. If Jumba Aku, for example, who is making noise on Facebook today, talking about counting this, that, and so on. If he cared about the Ambazonian people, he would have even known that Professor Lumumba, who came here to the United States, Jumba Aku is just in Pennsylvania. He's just an hour or two drive. When they were coming to D.C. to raise money, because they knew that money would come out, they all drove and came. But when a big man is coming like Professor Lumumba, Jumba Aku could not even make an announcement on his wall to give people courage. You only think about the thing that favor the groups that you support, and not the thing that favor the people of Ambazonia. Let me say this very clearly. All of you, first of all, I want to tell people that I don't recognize any of you as leaders. I recognize a government that is functioning. And even in that government, there are people that I don't recognize their ideologies, because it's contrary to the Ambazonian people. And let us be very clear. Let us be very clear with this. In order for you to postulate a proper strategy, you must get a calm head. And you cannot get a calm head when you have thieves and revolutionary armed robbers who are trying to disturb the revolution. And so I have the obligation of the, I have the mandate from the Ambazonian people that this platform has become their platform to ensure that, you know, we as a people of Ambazonia will try to clean the house, and remove all the thieves out of the house. Listen, let me tell you people something. And let me be very clear for some of you who don't know. You know, it is my obligation as Eric Tato, as an Ambazonian who has lived majority of his life on Ground Zero, who knows a lot of things that's going on Ground Zero, who understands what it means to have suffered injustice on Ground Zero, to preach to you without fear or favor about what is going wrong and about what is going right. And let me say this very clearly. For those of you who don't know, I want you to get it very clearly. You will not succeed in trying to destroy the Ambazonian independence movement. All those of you who come with crocodile tears, crocodile videos, all of you, be rest assured that me, Eric Tato, we, the Pope Ambazonia, will not allow you to prevail. I laugh. You know why I laugh? Because a lot of you have not understood. Please, if you join, you share on WhatsApp, on Messenger, let everybody come in. You know, they have blocked my Facebook in a way that if I come on live, some people don't receive notification, not all my contacts. Because you know what I mean. Because they know that this guy is on fire. And there is no way that they can stop me since, I have decoded all of them. And I've ensured that they don't function in their normal business of duping and scamming people and receiving money. I want to make these points very clearly before I will talk today about all these women, these agency women, all these people. I said that I will never reply. I'll only discuss the way forward, and I'll only come and reply when it's very necessary. So, because some of these thieves, they heard that I will not reply, they thought that they could use that advantage, knowing that, oh, if we can't talk now, or talk because I don't want to say no, you know, I reply. I'm a very dynamic man. The way you come, that's the way I take you. That is why another thief, who is a celebrated, immaculate criminal in this revolution, I'll call his name here, Tapang Ivo. He went to his war and was trying to talk about, oh, Eric Tato did this in Twitter and this. I just look and laugh. You say things that are not true. You fabricate stories because you know that social media is a large space. It's like a bar. You push, go and tell him that I am waiting for that live video and I'll come and destroy him the next minute. When he comes live, when he's done, I'll come live the next minute. Because in this revolution, what we have to do is that we must make sure. Some person, there's no sound. Let me see. I'm sure there's sound. Is it okay? If there's no sound, you have to check in your this thing. If there is sound, let me see. Yes, please. If there's sound. Okay, volume is fine. Perfect. Check your phone. Good. Now, you know that in a revolution, you have to understand that it is war. And just as we say, Mapani is a criminal, a Kema Patrick is this, you expose a Kema in all sorts of ways because you consider a Kema as an enemy. And I will also expose you people who are also enemies of the revolution. So don't tell me about the fact that there is division. Today, John Baku is crying about unity. What unity? That's what I want to ask. What unity? You know, let me tell you people something. If you don't know, I have said it and I want to still say it now. Let all of you listen. I will start one thing after the other because I have a lot of things to say today and I hope that I make this video as short as possible. Let me start. Number one, there is a criminal group. There is another group that is innocent. That does not know, that does, some people say the link does not provide sound. If the link does not produce sound, please go to the Facebook page. Go to the Facebook page itself. Now, for those who don't know, there is this group called they are trying to form what they call, I know all of them who are there, and they will be shocked that I have this information. Let me just go to specifics. I want Ambazonian people to listen how some people have become so criminal. And I have told some of the people who called me, let me go there clearly and try to begin to push all of these things out. They have made even a uniform. I will show them the uniform that they propose. You know, because when these people, when people start some things that are good, other people think that, you know, it is time for them to enter inside and destroy it. As Eric Tato, I am the Obasanjo of this revolution, and I have refused that the Ambazonian independence movement will not be mortgaged. You have criminals, people who have never raised a dollar for this revolution. They only sit. That is why you see people like Della, they were coming online and making noise how a leader will soon emerge on Ground Zero, how Ground Zero will take control because they have formed a group where they have brought in, they have their masters in the background and they are pushing these children on Ground Zero to show their faces, so that tomorrow now they will come and say, oh, that is what this other man who says is what of the AGC is trying to do. But I know all those things. And I want to tell you, Paul, that that is the same group people call the 12 Apostles of Fire. I have the group here. I am not in that group. So if you imagine that some people can sell information from that group to me, it's because they know that what people are doing behind is wrong. They have the 12 Apostles of Fire. They also have what they call great minds. In great minds, they discuss some other things. But 12 Apostles of Fire, they discuss specific things. In fact, there's an audio here that I might play if I decide, where you have some people who have connived with the Yumfu Sango and Nso Foncha. They actually come there. You know, they say they should capture retired military men who are supporting the movement, take them to their camps and use them to capture camps of other Ambazonian fighters because they have the techniques. I have all these facts here. And I want to tell people that it is death on arrival, because I have also implanted my own people in this Ambazonian, the 12 disciples of fire, who will be giving me information, and anything you discuss, I will know, and I will use this thing to arrest General Ivo. Tell the AGC people that me, Eric TATAW, I have said that this revolution is God ordained and none of you can destroy it. That's why anything you do, I will listen. Let me even read some of your names that you are there. General Nambere is there. They included Nambere is there. There is Dela, listen to the name to tell that I have all of you. I can tell you, you people are a total of about 100 and what in that group. Let me give you the number. You think that this movement, God will always expose all of you. I will get the number. How many people are in the group? Let me see. Just wait. It's a group that I've created. They call themselves 12. Just hear the name. The 12 Disciples of Fire. Oh, Jesus Christ. You people are not key Ambazonian people. Terrible people. Just a minute. Let me see. I know all of them who are there. I just want to get this very clearly. And then I want to start with the number of people who are there. For you to know. I know even people are there that my friends that I know that are there. They don't know. Some of them are crying. Well, but at that time, we do not know. Let me go up and check. And stuff like that. Even my friend Sikot is there from Batibo. Sikot, you are there. You don't even know that you are in the wrong group. I don't know how you people get yourself entangled into all of this mess. Anyway, there are 100, and I want to get the details. So these are things that Ambazonian people must be very watchful. just wait. Pull this out. I'll start reading the names, and then I'll come back to think that I should read the names first before I come to the total number of people who are in the group. There are 100, and I think I need to really get this clear. Well, that is okay. I will read their names, some of them who are in the group, and let them not be surprised, because I have people that have planted there, and I am going to ensure that that group is completely dissolved, because you people have stood there. You are using the children on Ground Zero to ensure that you deceive them, fool them. We don't even have resources. How much have you people put here? That's what I'm asking. How much have you people put in this movement? You want to take fighters because you are afraid of county by county. Let me be clear with you, because I know all what you guys want to do, and I will never allow it to happen as a person, and as a person who has a mind for the people of Ambazonia. You know, these are things that you have long planned, and you hope that there will be somebody that will just stay quiet and watch you snatch this thing from the Ambazonian people. Let me just read some of the names. You have they call this other one. There is Nambere, there is Omega 12. Dela, I want you to listen. You know, let me be very clear with you. There is General Nambere, there is Omega 12, there is Jimira Simon, there is what they call the Supreme Scorpion, there's Archer Donat, Asanda Stanley, Boss Divine, there's Angel Mike, the Liberator, there is Black Mamba, there is James Takanda, there is Honorable, there is Alligator, there is Atabon Kingsley, there is Ngwa Tangit 120. I think about 126 members, if I'm not mistaken. I'll get all the facts. Let me tell you very clearly. And you have Mustafa Tankunan. You have the Mediator. There is Dela. There is Edwin Ngongwe. There is Wantang Nevi. Rasta Zara. There is Mbi Solomon Ncha. There is Overcoma Agbo. Valerie Agbo, which is my brother from Akwaya. He's there. There is Fear Not. There is Nso Foncha. There is Ngalem Wilson. Rap Kuma. There's Yumfu Sango. There's another guy they call Sir James Baron, or what they call him. There is John Ba Akuru, Ebenezer Akwanga, and there are actually 116 members. So I have the total figure. I cannot name all of them. There are exactly 116 members in what they call in members in the 12 Disciples of Fire. There is General Ivo. General Ivo is also there. Now, you know, let me be very clear with you. You have people, they have, what have they done? They have come in, they have actually brought in some generals from Ganzo in WhatsApp groups. They are discussing, and then what are they trying to do? That's why I see General Ivo come every time and comes and says that, you know, we are soon going to have a general on Ground Zero. I want us to listen very carefully. You have people who are criminals, who are thieves, who are trying to destroy this revolution. Who is the master behind this group that a lot of these boys do not know? General Ivo and his master, they are working to ensure that once they have intelligence about all these groups and all these camps, what will they do? They will now come and capture the camp and put them under the ADF. Whereas these people, they are launching their affairs soon. I'll keep on saying it. It is supposed to normally be what they call the Ambazonian Military Council and so forth. Just started talking about it. And then the boys say no. They will prefer to call it AMF, which is Ambazonian Military Force. I have all these details. And let us be very clear. Let us be very clear with you people, Della and the rest. I have told some of, when I posted, that's why I see John Baku when I made a video, started talking about count by count, because he knows that I've already had the details. John Baku and the rest, these are people who are in groups. I have screenshots that I can post later, but it was not going to help the revolution anyway. I only say the thing because myself, I'm screenshot. You know, you have people who will go, they will go and talk in groups, tell people what to post, the right things, and then if they want to write about every tattoo, they will write and put a name like Edwin Tar to make sure that it's a bang name. They create fake names, they write, they post it and say, oh, bang man is talking about Eric Tato. When they want to write, that is what they do. But I don't have time for all those things because there are bigger things to fight. And this is one of the big things that I'm fighting against, the corrupt nature. And some of you, listen, let me tell you post something. I have already instructed some of my people among the 116 people that are in that group that get me all the information, get me the discussion of their various camps, all those people. There are two enemies in this revolution. I have said it. Ayabacho and his gang, the AGC, you put enemies to the revolution before the republic. All that noise that John Baku is coming and making about unity all the time, unity this, unity has failed, and there will be no more collaboration with thieves of the revolution. You people should go to your way, stand there and stand fine, and make sure that, listen, we don't have time with people who think that unity is about the fact that we will come and raise money, and then people will take money and begin to share money and fight over money. There are a lot of people who are in that group, a lot of our commanders who are in that group, who do not even know the motive. Some of them, they have been fooled, and they are always there. They don't know what they are doing. They think that, oh, these people are truly for cooperation. I've spoken with some of them. When they saw my post, they contacted me. Now, ask yourself, why this big question? Why is it that all of you, Della, John Baku, all of you, Ebenezer Kwanga, why are you poor afraid of county by county? That is the question I'm asking you. Don't you come from a county? Did you fall from space? If you qualify county by county as tribalism, county by county that is big, that is embodying all people, everybody, people in the county. What about block by block that had just a few people, like the ADF with 12 people, or Sokadev with 20 people? Is that no more tribalism where friends were fighting against friends, where they were capturing camps in Batibo? Let me ask you people a big question. When you were back there in Cameroon, before you went and did your passport, you, Della, and the rest, John Baku, all of you people, when you were in Cameroon, before we are breaking out and coming Ambazonia, before you go to do your passport, what would they ask you? They will ask you that go and bring your certificate of non-conviction, and you must go and do it from your division of origin. Why? You people don't have divisions? What is the problem? Why are you people so scared if it's not thief-free? Let me tell you people something. That this revolution has taken a new phase, and there is no way you can begin to say that county by county is tribalism. And who said that if they go by county, they will not cooperate? We have explained from the beginning of this project how we're going to be cooperate in terms of our county by county. I've said it very clearly that is where we have the biggest form of cooperation, because when we have 13 generals, 13 governors all over, just like what people are pretending to form under the Ambazonian Military Force, Ambazonian Military Council. We'll have all these people together. What will they do? They'll be in a meeting. They'll be in a council where they will discuss on how they can transfer material. I have said here very clearly that under the country-by-country approach, we will buy material and register it under the Ambazonian Federal Army or Ambazonian Federation, the Ambazonian, the Federal Republic of Ambazonia, so that if it is going there, if it is going there to the BLM, we know that this is going to the BLM county, but this material can be moved from the BLM to FACO to any other area. Now, some of you come, you are making noise, you are talking this, oh, it's tribalism. Let me tell you something. We will not and ever collaborate with people who are thieves, who are revolutionary criminals. Before I come to that, let me say this very clearly and take it to these women, these AGC women, three or four of them, who call themselves, who think that they can send some chickens, people who have their necks like duck fowls, like ducks. Some people who are behaving like, you know, you see people who are extremely primitive, some foolish people who don't know their left from their right. You come, you go and stay on a live show, you are calling every TATAW's name from 1st to 31st. I will ask you this question, that who do you call women of valor? Who are women of valor? That's what I'm asking you. You want to rally Ambazonian women against every TATAW? Have you succeeded in rallying your small groups? That's what I'm saying. Have you succeeded? No, let me ask you people something. I look and laugh. And you see, a lot of people, now I remember that I told you, Paul, one thing, that there is somebody who is going to go on Ground Zero very soon. I told you about a general that one of these days, somebody will go on Ground Zero, that they are preparing to stage something on Ground Zero. And what did I tell you? Very soon, as you're watching this video, you see a video that Ayabacho is on Ground Zero, because they are struggling to stage all videos and bring it to us for it to make new. I have all these things, and let me be very clear with you people. You see, the issue about me is that I am too smart, and we are blessed as a people to ensure that before anything happens, we already decoded. Now, Ayabacho Lucas will soon appear on a video. That is an old video that they shot in parts and they kept. Oh, it's a new video that he has not gone on Ground Zero. When I told you, remember some time ago, I told you people, what did I tell you people? That Ayabacho is going to stage something on Ground Zero, because they have all failed and they want to continue to have contribution from you. I will still say it here. Do not give your $1 to Ayabacho. Do not give your $1 to any group. Sponsor your counties. Now, they always want to do things that will make us appear, make them appear as though they are doing great things. As I'm telling you, before I finish this video, you see it on social media. I already have the video, but I knew that a time will always come when I will crucify them before they put those things on social media. I said it more than a month ago for those who follow me. Dela, you remember that Ayabacho is planning to go on Ground Zero. They are planning to stage something to look like Ground Zero. And now I have received the video that they have sent to me. And you see it on the walls of all these AGC activists that are sponsored, because that is what they are good at, propaganda. So Ayabacho, it is a bad thing that you think that you can continuously deceive the people. When I will finish, you see it. You see Ayabacho will be making with Ambazonian flag. Somebody who did not celebrate Ambazonian flag, he has taken an old video and then he will bring it out, make sure people will feel, say maybe, oh, this man just come out Ground Zero, because they do things and then they hold videos and wait. Because, you know, these are people who are expert in doing propaganda. So let us be clear with it. Now, I'm not telling you because you see the video and I want you people to know that that is how it is. So a good somebody is always like it's in Ecom, Nigeria, because of course he cannot go on Ground Zero. So let us be clear with this. Now, I want to go now to these women that they call women of valor, that this other bogus criminal, Tapang Iwo, who is a thief from birth, who will come and be saying that he's Red Dragon. He's moving away from the things that he's supposed to defend and trying to hide behind women. Ooh, Tapang is a fundamental criminal who cannot, normally those are children that will not talk when we're in the university. He's my classmate. So I'm waiting for him to come and do the video. That's why I'll continuously tell him that he's a thief. He's a celebrated criminal. And let me go to these women. Come and see the women that Tapang and his gang, they call themselves that they are women of valor. Women who are moving around Maryland here. They are moving around DC. They are moving somewhere in Pennsylvania. They don't have nothing that they do. Is that how Ambazonian women are? Do you see Ambazonian women? Ambazonian women will concentrate themselves in making sure that they participate in march and give money. Those are who they call themselves leaders because they don't want to contribute. How much have they contributed? Oh, so I heard that one went and slept in front of the UN for how many days and think that that's what has made her so big. Let me be clear with you. Now, I want you to know why I call these women. Listen, this is war. And I respect every woman. I respect every woman. And I'm continuously going to respect women. But I do not respect women who are rotten in their approach or in their approaches. Let me show you something. Now, look at this picture. I want to show you something so that you see. Now, this is, they call this one, I'll show it here. This is the one of the women that they say her name is Abu Free. I want to call her name because this is time to clean them out. Abu, look at Abu Free on a show that Ayaba Cho was running. Abu Free was insulting Sako, even when Sako was not on the show. This is it. You see Abu Free, she said, Sako show account now, rat them go see inside. That's a woman of valor who is insulting our president. And you think that I should look at that kind of woman and say that she's not a prostitute? Tell her that she should come. I'll post all these things. I want to go to another one. This is Sako. The Dr. Sako is here. The other they call Vivian Mbangwe on Sako's live show. Which Ambazonia woman has a time to go where the Ayaba is making video and insulting Ayaba? I can't say it the way it is because these are people who are criminals. Look, that's Vivian Mbangwe insulting Sako. This is it. Say this Sako is a shameless professional thief. That's a woman of valor. And you think that this is it. Look at this. This is it. You see this? These are the women that they call women of valor. Let me go and show you another one that this Abu Free, who is a professional Ashawo, like somebody described her here, international Ashawo. That's why she was saying that president my ass. That's Abu Free saying, calling Sako president my ass. So when you look all of this, listen, I want to tell you a very easy thing. You know, the issue about women and trying to make all this issue. I see somebody trying to talk about my wife and stuff like that. There is never going to be a day that will compare women of substance and women of who are like loose cannon. Like all these AGC criminals. Let me tell you something. If you see a woman who is insulting somebody here that your ass, I took all this, I kept this all this down because people think that I don't have issues. Listen, this is war. In war, you insult people who try to disrupt. You, who is saying that they shouldn't insult them? Now I want to ask you a big question, because you know the people think that some of these women should actually be left the way they are, because people hope that when you insult them, they will actually try to look at that and say, look at women, look at how somebody's calling somebody your ass, and then you say that who else can behave like that if not prostitutes? They're only prostitutes who use carnal language or carnal languages. And some of you come and say that, which I have the screenshots here. How can a woman be a woman of valor? A woman of valor, and then she's insulting somebody that you ask. That's what I'm asking. No, that's a question I'm asking you. Some people say, I will never stop insulting them. If that is what is going to make me lose popularity and credibility by kicking out all these thieves in the revolution, so be it. Any day that the Ambazonian, majority of the Ambazonian people tell me that, stop this, do this, I'm going to stop it. But let me tell you people something. Of course, like somebody saying, those are mad women. Those are criminals. Those are gang leaders who have been put in place, positioned by, okay, take for example, Professor Lumumba came here. Somebody like this one, they call her, is Vivian here, who is turning around. I heard that he took the sister's husband, as people say, and which is the truth. She's just around here like a vagabond. She came and said that because she has refused to even come to the hall to come and acknowledge the prayer of Professor Lumumba, she went ahead and posted that. Most of you saw that. Somebody drew my attention to it and said that he's thanking Wada Wush Wan Komreto for connecting Professor Lumumba to the Ambazonian community. It's a big disgrace that when people are doing that thing, when Professor Lumumba came here, you could not even come to see a man who has substance. But you stay behind, you are posting things only to make sure that people should not see that it's the interim government or some other person who brought the person here. The person did not even know how Professor Lumumba got to America. The person did not even know the program, and then you come and want to give credit to some strange person. So because one person who is from a village knows a particular person, another person from that village cannot know that person. Professor Lumumba was only made to be known by one person. Let me tell you, today I'm cleaning the house, and I want to be clear with all of these thieves of the AGC that I have said it, that they are my number one enemy. And that is the point. Suppose the women are women of valor. No, I did not talk about the Ambazonian women. I talked about those few women, those two, three, or four women. Now, I want to answer to this fake profile this Asaba judge, whether it's judge within the same agency pool who changed one profile to another, and they think that they think that they can come and use it to inflame their opinions. And somebody said you don't have to insult women. Let me tell you something. Generally, women should not be insulted. But women who show carnality and who behave the way they behave, let me be ever clear with you that I will continuously insult them. That they are criminals, they are prostitutes, they are whatever I choose to describe them. Because no real Ambazonian women can come and say, "President, my ass," no matter what. So I am only trying to recompense the gesture, trying to give them back the way they are. Ambazonian women are women of valor, not some women of loose virtue like somebody just wrote. Those are not women that can sit on a table with Ambazonian people, because you know when you go up, you go and begin to insult a president that, yes, you might not accept with, you might not agree with Sako, you might not agree with Dr. Sako. No problem. Tell me why you don't agree with the Dr. Sako. Oh, come on live and bring your point and do the insult the same way. But you don't go on somebody's wall, you go and be saying, your ass, president, my ass. I mean, you can say feed this. Now, I want to ask you, calling somebody prostitute and calling somebody my ass, which one is worse? Is it not us? Is it not us? Listen, let me tell you something. In this revolution, we are not going to condole with women who have reduced themselves to mere street girls. And you're going to get from me exactly, Della Della, go and put on your wall that I have still insulted those women. And call all those who are loose and fake activists who do not know their left from their right, who do not know how to dress well, who do not know how to speak good English, who wear traditional cats with big chains like dogs, and whose necks are like giraffes and dog fowls, to come and put on their walls that I have still insulted those women. I will still tell you that those women that I have called here, they are not Ambazonian women, and they cannot be recognized because they do not have the interest of the Ambazonian people. They are working for a group, and they are my enemy, and the line has been drawn. Today to tomorrow, I will tell you that I will stand for Grand Zero, and in the days ahead, I will be raising more money for Grand Zero to various counties, and none of you can stop that. And let it be very clear that the Ambazonian people have a resolve, and they have decided to fund their counties. So no matter what you do, let me be very clear with you that if you have women, you, Della, go and put on your wall. I'll send you the screenshot. Write to me, I'll send it to you. Tell them that, why did they start insulting Dr. Sako, that president, my ass? Is ass not most canner than prostitute? That's the question I'm asking you. So when you have all these people who are trying to follow a revolution to put you on a path that's going to move, you have some dirty mouth, stinking women who come on public and they're insulting the president. And when you come and insult them, you know, some people say, oh, you're insulting women. They started by insulting my president, and I cannot take it from none of them. Dr. Sako is my president. If you insult Dr. Sako, why will you not insult Seseko, who is in jail? Let me tell you today, any of you here, do you know that Seseko has gray hair? Seseko is hair so on a white for inside jail. Where go come on and go see him for? Remember this video, that Seseko has developed gray hair, and that they even forced them 2 days ago to sign a document to take them to the military court instead of the court on the 1st of November. Seseko, your whole hair in a gray, white. Every day he's giving poor courage that you should go on. Let me tell you something. The only way forward is to first and foremost start by kicking out all these thieves in the revolution. And I want to say that when I see Jonga joke, for me, as Eric Tato and as a Pope Ambazonia, we have known those who are thieves in this revolution, and they'll be kicked out. They'll be put out. Don't mind all these conspiracy theories about the fact that you cannot insult women. Women will earn respect based on the things they do. I cannot insult a woman who is respectful. Even if a woman does one mistake, two mistakes, all these people that I'm calling their names, there are people that have been perpetual, they have been consistent in destroying this revolution, in insulting people. You see them do all just left, right, call my name. The other one, the caller is Abu Free. Another, I'm calling her name now, she'll be very happy. She'll go and do another audio saying that, oh, she has a good job, she has this. Contribute money to the AGC and leave people to contribute to their counties. If people have good jobs, why are you people crying about county by county? I'm asking you people, you come and make noise here. We know everybody in America. We know what you people do. People work and make noise anyhow and stuff like that. In the days ahead, all of you who are making noise will ask you, post your VIN number. Let us know the kind of car that you drive. Post your bank account. Let us know how much you have in your bank account. Post us your job. You can block your address and all that. Tell all your company where you work. You have even some this other man. Listen, let me tell you something. Gang Zero will be in charge through their counties, and we will not have nincompoops trying to destroy this revolution. So long as I stay here, you continue listening to the truth. And all those women that you call women of valor, they are not women of valor. They are women of loose virtue, like my friend put it. They are women that don't have no use, no substance.
and they cannot even party where Ambazonians are partying. So that one should be clear to you people. So don't come and say, oh, he's insulting women. Who are women? I'm insulting women. Let me put S there. Those are two women. They're not even qualified to be considered as. In fact, those one, they are women is out. Let me tell you people something. You come and you are making noise. And when I look you people, I laugh because you take small people who went when the university they could not talk, they cannot make noise. You have somebody like my friend Tapang Ivo, who can only come and talk about me on social media or on groups that people don't know us one on one. We have a group there like Journalists of Integrity that Mark Barita is there. When I write in that group, Tapang cannot talk because our edict is English. He knows because everybody in that group is ex-student, ex-journalist. Everybody knows everybody from Cameroon. All of us in that group. Every journalist that is there, all Prince Hansen, they are there, everybody. They would ask them, Tapang cannot talk when I write in that group. Then he comes here, he's making noise. Somebody says, stop insulting girls. Are those girls? Are those girls? Those things you call them girls? People come and insult somebody that you ask. Are those girls? No, let's be objective. Let me tell you some women will always earn respect. Why would I insult my woman if she respects me? That's the question. Go and look in the Bible. Jesus did not mingle with people who were trying to destroy the temple when he got into the church. But Jesus mingled with sinners who accepted the fact that they were sinners and who were ready to change. Even on the cross, Jesus forgave a thief. So you cannot come here every day. You're trying to scatter the revolution. You think that I'll come and stay quiet. No, I will not. So Fujon saw himself said that the grand jury recognizes only the IG. Why is that you probably come and said confession? John Baku is saying this one, they are saying this Ayaba will be sending them. Now you have gone and brought an old fake video to come and show Paul that Ayaba was on Gang Zero. On Gang Zero where? Man, let me tell you something there. All of us, we know you people and we know what you are up to. And we here, we are sure of what we are doing. I'm not going to trickle down. I'm not going to hear all those small conspiracy theories trying to bring about women of valor. Who are the women of valor? Tell them that they don't exist in my dictionary. If that's how some women were going to be, if that's how women will call men their ass, then no man should get married to any woman. Those are not women. That's why they're sitting turning around like David. They don't like the guy body way David don't come out, don't be frustrated. They don't know their left from their right. So listen, let's respect ourselves if you want to be respected. They are bad girls. That's the name to give them. They call them women of valor. Now, like I was saying, and we'll continuously say this. Today is the day that I'm cleaning the house. And to let Jumba Akuru take it back to his camp, those who send him to come and test water, that Eric Tato is saying that we will not cooperate with anything that has to do with Ayaba and General Ivo. I've told even all of you in the AMC and the AFC or whatever I call that group that so long as Ivo is there, I will use that group to capture Ivo. That's what I've said. Tell him that Ivo and Ayaba, they are my number one enemy until they prove to me beyond reasonable doubt that they can actually change and prosecute this revolution as from their hearts. But so long as they stay in this revolution, trying to destroy this revolution, Eric Tato will arrest them. I will arrest Ayaba and Ivo through that group, through that the 12 disciples of fire. Deladeya, their brother, Yupo Sango, and his friend, Nsofoncha, who have stolen so badly from the interim government, who arrested Ekema and took 10 million, they are in that group, and you think that is a good group. That's why Fritz Takang, too, is even ignorant. He does not even know what's happening in the group. He will come on a live video saying that he endorsed it. He should ask questions. If you want to have respect, and you want to ensure that you are, you know, they'll say, oh, you attack everybody because all those people, I don't know if it's that they don't see or they are blinded or what, I don't know. Respect yourself. You want me to respect you because we have come to this revolution to stay and to change the dynamics. And I'll still continuously say that anybody, any activist who wants to make noise, including those ones that have their necks as long, you see people who talk on Facebook, you see how they are making like imbeciles. You see somebody will be talking, you have somebody who wear a shirt, a big chain, a country cap, wear the other one will wear this thing, how they call this carries on the hand, like a traditional doctor, they come and they are making noise. You know, you have a fake profile, people whose parents are lavishing in Ambazonia, who are supposed to be fighting for the independence of this country, they are there, they are making noise left, right. I fought myself to the top. We fought, we struggled, we suffered, and we think that other people should not suffer. That's why we are fighting. And you have people who have the golden opportunity, and then they are here, they are making noise, disturbing, and all of that. Let me tell you something. We have come to stay in this revolution. And the Ambazonian people will not tolerate anybody, whosoever, man or woman, able for that. In fact, Those are girls you call women of valor, tell them that after that they are hemophiles, because they do not behave neither like women nor men. They are just so much in the middle. So tell all the Abu Frees and Vivian Banwi and the rest of those are criminal gangs in the name of women in the AGC that I have said that officially I'm coronating them as hermaphrodites, and there is nothing they're going to do about it. And if they think that they can destroy this revolution, I have told them that if they want to use the soft power that people have for women to try to invoke pity on them, I'm going to still destroy that pity from day one, because they do not deserve every pity. In fact, they are hermaphrodites. And that's what I've said. What nonsense. You have people thinking that this revolution, you think that this thing is a joke? You come and say, oh, they are killing people. I mean, look at them. They're moving around here, useless women. No, nothing to do, trying to back up. Ayabacho is doing all the bad things in this revolution. You would see them. They'll come and say this, come and say that. Jumba Aku, that's supposed to be an objective man, will come and make noise. The same person who caused all the confusion here, they will come and say, oh, shutdown will be on this date. Jumba Aku will come and do this video that they have agreed on this date. When you go behind, go and tell General Ivo and the rest in that their group that announced that it's on this date. Then they'll tell Bob Herbert that come and confirm it, because they want to undermine the interim government. It's a pity. We will not jump back. Who will take the message from me? Let them tell you. You are my big brother. I respect you. But we will never cooperate with you and your gang of thieves. We will never cooperate with Ayabacho. All that cooperation is because you people no longer have money. We will not. If you like, you go and form what is AMCO, WFCO, whether it's Cali Women Association, or to come and be. If you like, you bring Jesus to come and put in that group. So long as Jesus does not belong to county, because why are poor afraid of the counties? We will make sure that we do not contribute any money there. People, in the days ahead, people announce their governors' manuals, already doing election. We will support those counties, and we will use our influence and our love from the people to raise funds for our counties and defend our counties. That is it. So if you don't belong to a county, ask yourself why. Why are you afraid of your county? Now, I go to the interim government before I close this show. You must have heard, and it is no longer news that there was an issue with this money that Dr. Manchu took some money. You see, the problem about life is honesty, and I owe the Ambazonian people the truth, and I want to seize this opportunity to thank Dr. Manchu, who is in Colorado. You people heard the trouble that came out during the fundraising here in DC during the Unity conference. They said Dr. Manchu took money and ran with it, and there was a lot of confusion. Yes, he actually went with the money. He ran with the money, whatever we want to describe it. But what is important now is that Dr. Manchu has refunded some of the money, maybe all of the money. I got information from a very confidential source that the interim government has received some of that money from Dr. Manchu. So if the interim government receives money that brought a lot of controversy, why would Secretary Chris Anu not come on a live show to acknowledge? Why would the interim government not put out a communique acknowledging that, oh, this money that we had this confusion, this man has actually paid 10 or 13,000 or whatever, because I heard that about 13,000 has been given back to the interim government. Why is the interim government quiet? We don't want us politics in this thing. I still want to tell them that we, as a people, we are political, and we are only thinking on how to persecute this revolution. Dr. Manchu has given part of that money, all of that money. You people should get it. And I want to thank Dr. Manchu that despite the rift, the tension, the embarrassment, he still took upon himself to honor himself as a doctor to give back that money. I don't know how he got it. I don't know how he did it. But the end point is that he has honored himself and he has earned my respect unconditionally for doing that. You have few Ambazonians that will do that. And I want to thank him so much, so much, so much for ensuring that we as a people, we have that particular money back in the account. So it's left for the interim government to come back and come and tell us that, oh, this man gave this money, why are they quiet? Because now they have destroyed that man's name. That, oh, he took money, they did this, because the money had a lot of problems until checks were being cancelled. And if that man has surely by every means get some money, and then he has given some of the money back, or all of the money, why is our government quiet? Because, you know, we have people who think that people should have bad names or whatever. No. If somebody, something happened that went wrong, although that man did not have the opportunity to explain himself, and then now he has come out and he has given that money, why would the government stay quiet? I mean, when did he give this money? Even if it were yesterday or 2 hours ago, the first thing that any government would have done is to come out to clear that man's name. That man is a man who has a reputation, he's a doctor, and you cannot keep people in the blues like that. So the government, please, Secretary Chris Anu, Dr. Sako, our president, and Secretary Tabenyang, Auntie Irene Angwa, I know all of you who are running those things in the interim government, If you have received money from Dr. Mancho, come out and tell us that you have received this money and thank him and make a letter for Ambazonian people to be clear and tell us how all this money that the interim government received, over close to 40,000 during the unity conference, because now it is clear that no other leader received that money after the confusion. So you people should tell us how you people have used the money, or why you are still failing to acknowledge the fact that Dr. Manchung has given part of this money or all of the money that was in his keeping. I think this is how we're going to move forward. And we as a people, we will continuously ask and pray that the interim government should not relent her effort in trying to adopt workable strategies. So Dr. Manchum has given that money back to the interim government, and I've had confirmation, and it is only obligatory for me as a seeker of the truth to come here and tell the Pope Ambazonia that if you have any grudge, if you have any grudge against Dr. Manchum, he has acted gentlemanly like no other human being has ever done in this revolution to refund that chunk of money up to more than $13,000 or $10,000. I don't know the exact amount, but I know he has refunded the money, and we thank him so much for that excellent act and gesture of honesty that is now profound, and that earns him a more better title as Dr. Emeritus, although he might still be in the academic field. He has done a lot, and we think that we thank him for coming out very powerfully to do this reimbursement now, or this reform. So the interim government has the obligation to come out and talk to the people. So I will not want to make this video very long. I have made my point, and I'll continue to talk about these people of the AMC and AFC. They have gotten my voice, and they know exactly what I'm talking about. And I've also talked to the Ambazonian women that I don't owe any woman any apology for calling her a prostitute, because I call them based on what they have been doing. And any woman must learn to earn respect. And any woman who goes calling the president of the Federal Republic of Ambazonia your ass is either a prostitute, a homophobe, or a complete street prostitute. And I do not have any reservation for ensuring that I say this. And any Ambazonian woman who also call either Dr. Sako or President Seseko my ass will have me as an activist, as a lover and a defender of the flag to face. So that is the point. I owe no apology. Tell the Tapangs who have been stealing money in this revolution, tell the Ayabas, tell the Deladelas, all those criminals who have stolen money all their lives in this revolution, that Eric Tato is saying that he owes no apology to any of those prostitutes in the agency, because they do not represent 1 billion of the Ambazonian women. So that is it. And I want to be clear with you that if you are ever dreaming in your life that you deserve this government, not now that I've had confirmation about Seseko's gray hair, you will not succeed, because I pledge my unconditional allegiance to the interim government, but I will not also relent in ensuring that this government toes the line and makes sure that she does what is right for the Ambazonian people. Yes, and I end by telling them that today I have graduated them from prostitutes to homophobes. All those women in the AGC, is either you change or you continuously facing me. And take it from me today that you can never mobilize the Ambazonian people against the voice of the truth. You never mobilize the Ambazonian women against the voice of the truth. I will speak it, I will say it, and I will say it as it is. And I'm not begging you. If you think that I doubt it, go to London and continue to do your oil deal, because we don't have any space for thieves and scammers and manipulators in Ambazonia anymore. So that is the message, and take it from me. Keep on manipulating my account. Keep on making sure that notification don't get to my viewers. They will still come to watch it later and they'll understand what I'm saying. That is it. Thank you very much for the Ambazonian. God bless you for your support. God bless you for everything. And of course, we have something big that we'll be doing on the 1st of November, somewhere in the United States. I'll be moving there. I'll be driving a couple of hours to go. When the time is near, I will announce so that we don't have some of these Pamelas to come and destroy the beautiful work of the Ambazonian people. God bless you. And once again, I thank you so much, Dr. Mancho, for giving back that money. And we look forward to having the interim government coming out to declare or to clarify this particular fact. While we also want to thank the AGC people for manipulating people with fake old videos from Ayaba to show that he's from ground zero. We know all those things, and we will not give our money to any group. We will support our counties. So if you are listening, the next edition of my show or my live stream will bring out some people who will be talking on behalf of their counties. While you go away, you can go to Sikot. Sikot from Momo County will be live after this live show. So he's supposed to come at 5. I'm sure that he's waiting for me. So God bless you, and stay blessed and stay committed. And know that the Ambazonian independence movement will end in a conclusive conclusion, and we will have our independent country without any interference of any sort of criminology or any sort of dictatorship. God bless you, and stay blessed once more.